New at 4, two Denver detectives have been cleared for their involvement in a shootout and hostage situation that ended with a wanted man dead. The decision coming down by the Broomfield's district attorney. Fox 31's Alex Rose is on it with that brand new body cam footage of what happened. Alex.
Yeah, Talia, the DPD fugitive unit was tracking Anthony Lanez's cell phone. They had a warrant for his arrest back in September of last year. So while the suspect initially was able to evade police, he ends up crashing his car and trying to carjack an innocent bystander on the road. That's the scene that these detectives are heading to. A warning, this all goes down very fast. We're going to pause the video and try to explain it bit by bit. Take a listen. All right, so you're going to see this second detective come up on the left of your screen right here. He pulls up with his truck and flanks the suspect with a long rifle. Lanez draws his gun, and at this point, no longer is holding that hostage that he has right there. Let's play the next 2 seconds of this interaction. So, according to the investigation, Lanez shoots the Denver detective in the neck. The detective fires around back with his long rifle. You can see the hostage gets pulled away, and then this detective fires several rounds. Lanez dies at the scene. District Attorney Brian Mason wrote in his decision letter, quote, given the totality of the circumstances and evidence, the prosecution cannot prove that the involved officers were not justified in using deadly force. He went on to say Mr. Lanez posed a grave threat to the lives and safety of others there that day. Alex Rose, Fox 31.